True story, I went to Target. You know, ladies, Target when you're trying to fancy it up. So I went into Target for one item. And as I was aisle strolling, I ended up on that Home Good aisle. I was like, I know good and damn well I don't need to be on this aisle. You know that aisle, ladies, when you see the decorative pillars and stuff, the ones that say live, love, laugh. So that means you gotta buy all three. Then I got over there and found one of them lamps that requires 16 light bulbs, knowing good and doggone well my husband ain't gonna know how to put them together. But I just threw it in the basket. And it's something about when you buy unnecessary things and things that you don't want. You have a special walk about yourself. So I'm up going to the register and I'm like, ooh, I got a bunch of stuff I don't need, but I'm happy and I'm excited. So I get to the register and the cashier goes, that'll be $132. I knew in my soul, in my heart of hearts, deep in my diaphragm, that I didn't have $152 in my account. I only had $32 in my account. But I would not be defeated. So I passed her that credit card with confidence. But right before she was getting ready to swipe it, I just started singing a good old Negro spiritual, holding it at the
no words change.
I was like, please, Lord, let this transaction go through. And you know, most people that work at Target, they hate their life, they hate their job, them the wrong people, you know, they give you bad customer service. So what do they do when your credit card doesn't work? They get loud with you. Excuse me, ma'am. You have another form of payment. Your credit card did not go through. Hey, hey, where's your inside voice? This is between me and you. Me and you. This ain't got nothing to do with the people on aisle 11, 12, and 13. Use your inside voice. So then what do? You start the process of elimination. Oh, is that organic chicken? I didn't need that. Take that off. Oh, that's three ply toilet paper. We can deal with one. My husband had a wipe anyway. Just one ply toilet paper. So I pass it to her again, and in my mind, the Negro spiritual was going on. She's like, it's declined, ma'am. I was like, well, I'm in my inside voice. I got the memo. I was like, well, do you guys have any coupons or discounts? She goes, no, but we have applications. So I work at Target. So now I get everything I want on discount. But I ain't mad. That's why I want one day I'm gonna swipe with swag. See, so, you know, in LA, the cliche thing to do, the posh thing to do is to have dinner parties. So like I said, I swipe with sensitivity, so if you invite me to dinner, I ain't eating the whole day. I'm coming with a full appetite. I'm like, oh yeah. And see, the people that invited me to dinner that night, they looked like they had a little bit of money. So on my way over there, I was like, ooh, they look like they got money, so I'm gonna have steak and shrimp and everything. Wrong. I get over there and they got hummus and cucumbers. I had never heard of hummus until I moved to LA. I'm like, what? 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 It's hummus. And I got there, I was like, this the whole meal? She was like, yeah. She goes, well, we've got garlic hummus, we got chickpeas. your lips. They be like, oh my God, are you gonna eat that? Be like, no, I'm gonna use my fork as a slingshot, throw it across the room. Yeah, I'll eat it! Suffer in silence like the rest of us. Don't worry about what I'm eating. So I took that unhappy eater home with me. I'm originally from Texas. Ain't Texas people here? All right, proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. Oh, Texas for you, yo. So I was like, you know what? I'm gonna take this unhappy eater home with me. I'm gonna take it home. I'm gonna show you what real food is. And like I said, I'm from Texas, so all my family members, my uncles and cousins, they're big gamers. So I brought him home with me, and as soon as this unhappy eater walked into my uncle's house, she was like, ah! Crystal! What is that on the wall? And I was just sitting there like, golly. Please don't let it be no roaches on the wall. What is she doing? So as I'm getting my story together that I was adopted, family. I was like, my uncle real, real proud of that. He caught that like 2 years ago. She was like, as in Bambi's father? I was like, I don't know about a father, but it can really be a late cousin, for real, for real. And she was like, oh my God. Oh my God. It's LA. Oh my God, oh my God, I cannot believe you people. First, watch it with the you people, bitch. Let's get that together. Oh my God, I cannot believe that you put that in your body. My body is my temple, my body is a vessel, my body is everything. I can never, ever, 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 ever put anything like that into my body. My body is not a graveyard for decaying flesh. I was like, bitch, you was just in the bathroom doing 2 lines of coke. What are you talking about? Not to mention, last week you had unprotected sex with a man that looked homeless. So I would say your body is definitely a place for decaying flesh. Don't say nothing at all. Or better yet, do it the old-fashioned way and wait till you get in your house amongst your family and talk shit like that.